Just for wait.
Graham McCarroll, the Middaugh third, here in the second.
Right up. Right up to it. Yep.
Whoa.
Finish.
Shot, Graham.
And up on top.
Great shot.
Yeah.
And John made some big shots in that game yesterday against Larry Pino. And
lots of them.
All the shots he was making yesterday were the kind that he has to make here, and that is positioning the stone to set up his skip. If you put this one in the wrong place, Wayne Middaugh can tap it onto his own, and then Wayne Middaugh can go for the two. It's got to be positioned correctly, blocking the area and protecting shot rock.
Gotta go hard, quick! Come on, you gotta get in there.
Okay. Want to tap?
Yep.
Tap that one into here. And if you bump that, it's fine.
Okay.
Just the weight.
Line's good.
Yep. 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 Hard. Hurry. Hard.
Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa. 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 Whoa.
Lock it on.
Right on the corner.
Right on the corner. Great shot.
Well, that yellow stone is surrounded.
Up there, I think.
Okay. Linda Ray, if there's something, as I suggested earlier, maybe something more at stake here for Middaugh to send the message to Werenich.
Just missed the sweep on your hair.
If you're Wayne Middaugh, you can't let that.
It just took a little of his handle too, coming in.
Color your decisions.
Right on the corner.
Watch yourself. Don't let yourself, you know, get too excited about the situation because you're not going to rattle this man, are you?
No, they've got to play for the end, for the cash. They've just got to play their game plan, and so far they've been doing that. Wayne played that tough raise in the first end, but that's his style. He'd play that against anybody.
Room.
Well. Well, well, well.
Line's good.
Oh, it's gonna break too much.
Oh, too much break. Whoa.
Trying to guard the possible rays.
Just clean.
Clean it.
With those two black ones in front of the yellow, either
line's
one could be raised back to try and remove that shot stone.
Oh, boy.
And the higher that stone is, the better off it is. It makes the double raise almost impossible. And
you hate it to go across into the yellow.
Oh, I know.
This one, right?
Still got the yellow on the yellow. On the black, eh? He's always going to have one.
What do we get if I make it, though?
Is it two?
Look, he looked at this here, but he can't get enough of it.
Just assume not.
He's looking at this one now.
Well, raising his rocks, I don't mind it.
Yeah, okay.
Because this one's buried all day.
Yeah.
There's a rock out in front of this one.
Yeah,
so
just a hair.
That one guard just thrown there.
Can I make that in turn? I think I can. Graham?
What?
I think I can make that in turn with hack.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Edge of the four.
Okay. If we rack this, this three rock isn't bad.
So he's gone to the original, his original thought.
Oh, yeah.
And this is the in turn he's talking about right here. And you heard Graham's comment, if you rack on this one, it's no big deal.
Wayne Middaugh, his first here in this second end. $2,500 at stake after Werenich stole $25 in the first.
Three. 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 Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, come on.
Go, go.
That's not bad.
Oh, it isn't.
It's not great. It's not bad.
Oh, man. That's perfectly darn good. That's not bad, though.
Well, it's not bad.
That's a gimme off that. That's a gimme off that one.
I almost got a hit and roll, don't I?
Yeah. Actually, you want to hit and move that.
Yeah, they can't move, so he shot rock and they got a free draw.
No, no. As soon as you hit it.
How about a guard?
I don't like that.
Well, how about
they went and looked at this one.
One here.
They can't leave this one here.
Well, the only problem is, if this is where Johnny's is, he can pretty easy.
Well, you can bury it better than that. You can bury it better than that. It's going to swing
if
in
hit
there.
The guard, well, you really got a problem. If I come to here, what's that do for us?
I like this.
I like this, too.
I like this draw.
Yeah?
Yep. Come right to it. Tap it.
Houdini couldn't make that shot, Jack.
That's less than me, right?
Yeah.
He can't stop them all, so he's going to come right in. And you heard John say, well, even if you tap it back, come right to the face of it. Of course, the answer was classic.
You know,
Houdini couldn't
think about that for a second.
I'm king of skins. I'm not a magician.
One. Yeah.
I guess he's got room off our yellow one, eh?
He's got room. How easy is it to go to the four?
Son of a gun.
He got some room off of this one, too. This is what they were talking. This is what Neil was talking about at the other end, coming off of that one. But you can't stop them all, so he's coming in here.
It was a good thought process. They thought about hitting a second shot, belonging to Middaugh, hitting the side one, decided that the draw was the better, then discussed
room.
Where the draw should go.
Heavy.
Well, they decided to come right
room.
In. They think this is the best way to protect and still have a chance for the steal.
That's why Graham's Carroll's comment was, it's not bad, because all of a sudden it put Werenich in a position where he can't protect everything.
Right off it.
They need some movement now, though. We've got to bring it right. It's got to come right in. It's got to come right to the forefoot. It's no good short. It's got to come all the way.
Every inch. Hard.
He's got this.
It's still there.
That one, you don't like this one?
Right, this is easier.
Just bigger?
The forefoot. Right? Anywhere on the inside.
Uh-huh.
Right, I only got to move it a couple inches. Yep. Center of the rock.
Okay.
Center of the rock with the intern, hit this one here. Come across, he has to move this stone just a couple of inches.
I gotta move it two,
out that
inches.
Way.
Yeah, just a hair on the inside.
Which would level it up here, give Wayne Middaugh his first skin, and even this final at $2,500 apiece.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Finish.
Finish a little.
Didn't.
Two big weight shots that haven't worked. That was a good chance.
And so another steal of $2,500 goes to Ed Werenich. Houdini, well, he may have gotten away with one right there.
When two-time world champion Ed Werenich started using the hammer, people laughed.
Hey, Ed, it looks like a toy.
Last year, Ed's team was the leading money winner on the Pro Tour. Now who's laughing? When Ed Werenich first used the hammer, people laughed. World champion Russ Howard is the winningest skip in Brier history and Ed's number one rival. Russ has chosen the hammer. Now who's laughing? For more information about the hammer with quick change faceplates, call 1-800-567-7757.
McCain has a tasty pizza snack.
They call them pizza pockets.
McCain!
Pizza pockets.
The great pizza taste will keep you coming back. McCain!
Pizza pockets.
Pizza perfection in a crust that's baked, not fried. So there's no leaks, no mess. Just taste. All taste and nothing but
McCain!
Pizza pockets.
No leaks, no mess. Just pizza perfection.
Well, I'll give it my utmost attention. I'll buy you tall, tall trees and all the waters and the seas. I'm a fool, fool, fool for you.
Ed Werenich, as he has done for the first two ends, puts the brush down for his lead, Neil Harrison, and it's been straight, two straight steals for Werenich, and he leads quickly by $5,000 here on two And you put it well, Ray. Two missed big shots, which you would expect Wayne Middaugh to make.
Well, especially the last one, because he could see it all, and he could, you know, he likes that. He just took a little too much ice because he threw it right down, and he just needed to move it a few inches. The last one was a very, very makeable shot, and one that he really likes to throw. So
now, by the same token, that was in a spot, as you see now, we've upped the ante. It's $3,000 on the line here in this third end.
Go, Pappy.
That was that straight spot, and we thought that didn't exist anymore.
I don't think it did. I think he got it a little bit outside, and when you're playing that much weight, there's no margin for error. He just needed it to curl a little bit more, and he might have move that other one, at least gotten the carryover by rolling in. Just hung out long enough that he couldn't get it. Looking for the 2 points again with last rock this end.
Here's the come around. We get a question from Don Campbell on the internet. He's asking about the synthetic brooms, about the hammer in particular. Eddie Werenich uses the hammer and promotes it. All eight players out there have the synthetics, and it's kind of what you like to use. I don't suggest that one synthetic is much better than the other. The hammer is a very good one, there's no question.
If you do surf the internet and try and get in touch with us, there you see our address, TSN Control at tsn.ca. We appreciate you writing us and letting and talking to us. We want to know, though, where you're writing from. So put your address down, please.
Right there. Get it there, all the way.
It's there. Yep.
Go.
Okay. That question came actually from Monty Denby. From Don Campbell. We'll try and answer Don's Campbell's question through the game. He's asking about body alignment, so we'll try and illustrate it and show it to you.
So one.
Close.
Scott Bailey.
Close. Line's tight.
This is a very typical skins end. You've got a guard up and some come-arounds now, and it's positioning of the stones, being able to tap out the opponents and leaving yours in good position.
$190,850 lifetime when you add today's $5,000 to Ed Werenich's total. So closing in on $200,000, could reach it today here in Halifax. Wow. Pat Perreault. Wow.
Looks like tighter line than yours.
Well, just away. Yep.
Oh, needs it.
Yep. Yep.
Needs it.
Well. Yep.
Hi! Needs it.
Hurry! Hurry!
Not there.
Fire. Gotta go. Gotta be. Come on.
Okay, good try. Back line, bounce it back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, what do you want to throw, Tet? Here? Okay.
Back line weight, he said. Try and move it back.
Two Canadian, two world championships for Ian Petley, 85 with Al Hackner, 1990 with Ed Werenich.
Clean it.
Finish.
Just a little extra weight.
Yeah, just a little firm.
Ed Werenich has stolen the first two ends. Wayne Middaugh has failed to score his two to collect the money.
A carryover is when the team with last rock scores one or blanks the end. And last end, Wayne had a chance for that carryover. He couldn't roll a shooter in.
Very good right now.
See if we can just get that.
You got to bang it.
Off the nose. Get that one. Yeah, if you can hit that onto the corner of that.
How about it the other way?
Well, yeah, that, if it runs, I will, yeah. Yeah, what? Just normal.
So there's a couple of options on this, depending on how much it curls. They're looking to drive the first black stone back into the pack and get rid of something off the forefoot area.
Yep, hard.
Ray's off the corner and...
Yeah, I was hoping to get more of it.
And he kills his own, too.
Yeah, if he gets more of it, doesn't kill his own.
Okay.
$200,000.
Wayne's going to have to remove the yellow stone for sure. He can't leave it there, otherwise it can be promoted. Hit and roll. He's in a good position here to get his 2 points.
Clean it. Good. Close. Firm board. Close. Out. Whoa, 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 whoa.
The roll, shot. Sit, peeks out the other side.
Hit left shot, rock exposed.
Yeah. Wait only.
Got room.
Wait on me.
This is the chance to get out of it right here, Linda, if you can get this around.
Okay, go then.
This is staying out.
So they're trying to get it close so they can use it if it's not right to the face.
It finishes well here, but he's got to get right to the face of it.
Come on, every inch. Come on.
It really moved in. They had to get it earlier, but because it stayed out, they couldn't jump on it.
Throw here. Here.
Okay.
And for the viewer watching, this is what we talk about when we talk about weight-sensitive ice. If you overthrow this, it'll hold. If you, Wayne wants back ring, back 12-foot weight, and you must give it to him, or you won't get the movement.
Yep, up, hard.
If you underthrow it, it'll make him move big time.
Hard, free.
Graham McCarroll.
Hard.
Ian Tetley, Scott Bailey, the brushes. Across the, what a beauty.
Watch how far he pushes it now. What kind of weight did he ask for?
Back line.
What did he get?
Just past back line.
Whoa, you're right on, Vic. Have you got it today?
Thank you. But to come across and catch the face of that Linda and then just to push it back and buy the stone on the button.
Well, like Ray said, if it went straight, it wouldn't make the shot, and not making the shot would have meant pushing the opponent's rock in probably to shot stone position. So it was critical to cross the face and push it out the back, and that's just what Graham did.
Isn't it interesting to see how, by John's stone staying out and then not getting it to the face, changed, there's the chance to get out of the end.
Just a draw.
Now a good shot by Graham. Now you're really in trouble.
Now, by the same token, did that stone come across the face enough that allows
leaves
him
a corner
to get into that shot stone, in fact, the one on the butt?
We're talking percentages. What is the percentage now? To freeze a quarter of a stone and get by a front rock? Yes, you can make it,
but
this whole game is based around percentages.
Get by the front one. Whoa.
It'll finish big time if you can just get onto the face of it. You don't want to hit it.
Yep.
You don't want to hit it and bounce in the open.
Right there.
Is that any good?
Yeah.
I mean, that was a more difficult shot. I mean, all three of those shots got more difficult as you moved along. That's a marvelous shot. And Kawaja played so great yesterday. Yeah.
You can try and move it. Shit. As long as you're on the nose, it's perfect.
Terrific crowd here today, Vic.
Same way?
No.
The weather's cleared up.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful day in Halifax. Yesterday, a lot of snow and ice.
Wayne first had a look at the double raise, decided that was just too tough to get rid of that Werenich stone, and now they're going to try and make a play on it with this outturn.
Whoa.
Clean it.
Whoa.
Clean it. Line's good. Great shot. Perfect. Great shot.
That is such great curling.
Graham McCarroll.
For a guy with a little bit of a flu bug, he's playing pretty well, isn't he?
He's playing great, and one of the reasons that was such a great shot is, look at Werenich's rock is still shot stone, but what has it got in front of it, especially? Lots of black stones that can be raised back onto it. It's another case where Ed Werenich can't protect against everything.
You're exactly right, Linda. You know, you come down into this area here, protect the tap back of this, but this two rocks here are lined up so they can come at you this way. You can see he walked over to say, how do we get a rock in here for a second shot someplace? Do we play the draw here?
For 2 yards. It's a tough shot. But
listen to them talk.
If I can get there. No.
that's not really good, though, is it?
I don't.
No, that's not.
I don't see any attraction to that shot.
All right. Do you want to freeze that?
I think just freeze it.
Or you want to tap freeze?
Yeah, you tap it. That'd be perfect. Actually, just tap this out of the way of that.
Yeah.
Hey? Maybe a foot. Okay.
Talked about coming down and freezing on this one. Tapping it back.
Yeah, if it's perfect line, we can tap it. I don't like anything here, really, to be honest with you.
My pen doesn't either.
So what they're trying to do is, again, move the rocks around so the position isn't good for Wayne Middaugh to tap his up.
Yep, tight. Right.
Playing for $3,000 here in this third end. Ed Werenich's first.
All right.
By tight, they mean inside. They know it's going to finish big time.
Whoa. Yep. Whoa. Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa. Good shot.
What if you play this now?
Well, we would be two.
You know, in most club games, you'd be really upset if you just taken your own off the button and left the opponent sitting too. But again, you're trying to build up to the last rock. Yeah. Ed now has a rock in better position, top 8 foot.
They talked about hitting this, first of all, back onto this one.
Bumping that now?
Removing that one.
Yeah, or play that.
You want to guard this?
Yeah. And I think then you'd still have
an
action off this back.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah. Yeah. I like that.
You like the guard?
Yep.
Okay. I definitely like the guard.
Hair less.
Middle. Hair less?
Yeah. Well, even if he does, it's not a gimme. Right? I think we got a guard, don't we? How many times can Eddie make the shot off the outside one against us?
What he's talking about is this one here. He said, you know, somebody else, Kevin Martin's going to come down, hit this here, and come right across. But can Eddie make that shot? I don't think so, he says.
And that was one of the things you pointed out to Linda, is maybe on the list of checks and balances that Wayne Middaugh has over.
Where is it?
Ed Werenich as the big weight shot.
Oh. Oh. Whoa. 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 Whoa, 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 whoa.
You don't want to come too tight here.
No.
Or let it curl too much.
Okay.
That's not bad, actually. Gives me more rocks to bang around. Gives me more rocks to bang around.
Yeah, yeah, you do.
Thank you.
You got to go right on that one, eh?
Yeah, about half a rock, eh?
Yeah.
It'll curl. You're here less than half, you're saying?
Yeah.
Well, Eddie's saying to himself as he saunters down the ice, you think I can't play these hit and rolls from 12 foot?
No,
down he comes on this half a rock he needs here, and to come right across into here. So lots of things can happen. You can come off this one here and sit there.
And he needs to get in for shot. Or at least take one away, because right now the two are sitting there for Middaugh to pick up his first skin of $3,000. Final stone for Werenich here in three.
Yep.
He'd love to make this.
He just he'd love,
they say, I can't do this.
Love to send the message.
Oh, this is straightened out a bit.
Go hard, Patty. Come on.
Over far enough, over far enough.
Okay,
or
we'll
dig in, it will.
We'll try.
So the two are there for Wayne Middaugh to pick up his first skin. 5,000 to 3,000.
Those heaters always go straighter than you think.
Yeah.
Elvis Stoico goes for the big one and gets the jump on taste. The taste of McCain Frozen Punch. Year-round thirst-quenching taste like grape. Orange and McCain Fruit Punch, made with real fruit juices for real fruit taste that makes McCain the punch of champions like Elvis Stoiko. Get the jump on taste, the real fruit taste of McCain Frozen Punch.
Go for McCain. Get the jump on taste.
Amanda.
What?
True or false? Botticelli painted The Birth of Venus.
The Lady in the Clamshell painting, right?
Ooh, that is so cool. I'd go out with him if he were alive.
If he were alive, he wouldn't go out with you.
Look at this. Come here.
Oh, my. Calypso's cool.
Dividing bacteria.
Cambodia.
And varied chemical composition. Some plants are actually carnivorous. Did you just see that? Go away! Wait a minute. What if that's your older brother?
Who knows?
Kevin?
We make maple leaf wieners for Courtney, who will only eat Mr. Broccoli if he hasn't touched Mr. Gravy. We make maple leaf wieners for Tim, who says peas explode in his mouth. And for Caitlin, whose scrambled eggs must be shaped like little boats. Maple leaf wieners have a taste made especially for kids. For Kenny, who won't eat anything with sauce, and Jason, who won't eat anything without sauce, there will always be maple leaf.
Wayne Middaugh has his first skin, $3,000, so he's within $2,000.
Looks heavy.
And for the first time in the game, Ed Werenich will have to score two to pick up the skin. He'll have last rock here in four, and we're playing for another $3,000.
Yep, right up tight. Tight as it'll go.
And in each hand, it's been a big weight shot that's been attempted and not made that has cost the skin.
Keep him out over here, though.
Yep.
And we talk about this a lot as well with skins play, because both teams are being so aggressive. As soon as the first guard goes up, which is of course on center line for the team trying to steal, you'll see the other team also come around it. That means a lot of the play is in the center line area.
No, don't touch it. Yep. 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 Yep.
Neil Harrison with his first in behind the center line, sitting top eight.
Line's good.
More, lovely.
Line's good.
Scott Bailey is employed by Craig's Contracting.
Line's good. Close.
Close. Just for
just
line.
Wait. No, just wait. Wait. No, line's fine.
You're bouncing.
Whoa. Yep, whoa. Yep, bounce it. Bounce is fine.
Whoa. Nose is okay. Real good.
Good job, Peppy. Good job, Scotty.
Werenich with the hammer. Needs to score the 2 points to get the skins. Ed was very close to making that. It just had to curl a little bit more.
Room.
At the end of the
lots of room.
At the end, you heard Wayne Middaugh, or Wayne Middaugh said, you just have to believe that they're going to run that much more
hard.
Straighter when you're up the weight like that. And that's what Ed just took a little too much ice.
Hard.
Oh, my God.
Come on. Oh.
Rex on that center line guard, Neil Harrison, who will be back at work tomorrow at the Scarborough Fire Department. We thank you for reaching us on the internet. Somebody wants to know, Linda, when will the McCain TSN Skins game come to the West Coast? That's from Peter Fry.
Well, it'll be nice to be close to home for me, and I think bids come in for the Skins game.
Right. Well, next year we'll be in Sault Ste. Marie, so possibly in 1997 is the chance.
Whoa.
That might be the first year, Peter Fry, and we thank you very much.
Line's good.
I don't care. Fight.
Again, if you contact us on the internet, we'd like to know where you're writing from, please.
Sit. Goodbye. Probably could. It looked like it was dying, eh? Same hack weight shot you threw the second end.
Okay. A little too deep, so it's a chance for Ed to get the hit and roll to the open a little bit.
Pat Perreault.
Actually, you could hit it right on the nose.
Yeah.
You'd be half covered.
Hard! Hard all the way. Hard! 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 Come on! Hard! 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 Hooray! Okay,
whoa. That was an easy question, of course. This is the real brain teaser, though, Linda. Our Air Canada brain teaser. Who curled 91% in a Canadian junior final and then lost to New Brunswick's Jim Sullivan? Answer a little later.
Oh, we don't have to answer them if we're doing the internet, Linda.
That's right.
I like that.
You're only tested so much, eh?
Lean it.
Just got by the front guard.
Yep, yep. Hard! Hurry! Hard!
Come on, harder!
Hurry!
Hard! Hard, right up.
Yeah, we said he was
having to make a little bit of an adjustment because yesterday we did see the intern run a lot straighter this time. Freeze, it's starting to move on them.
Yeah, I guess he froze there. Even if he froze there, that's not bad. I like that.
You don't want it to curl too much, though.
No, I know that, but...
Pat Perreault, his wife Jane, curling this year with Marilyn Bodo.
Not
expected
bad.
To be as, again, contenders for the Ontario Ladies' Championship.
It's to it.
We need curl.
I'm dying a bit now.
Well. Yep.
I got it.
Hard.
But all you can do. Do this, Graham.
That's the way we sit. Werenich stole the first two.
Where am I heading?
Replied with one in
pretty
the third.
Pretty much nose, hair high side.
One skin, that is, worth $3,000. Graham McCarroll.
Hurry!
He's going to move something around here.
Hurry! That's not bad.
That's fine.
That's fine.
Back weight.
Hit that and flop in there, eh?
Yeah.
This one will scoot back here somewhere.
Yeah.
Can I do it like with general hack weight?
Yeah.
Hack weight on this one here. Try and roll into this area here. Maybe move this one back a little bit, like so. You said scoot was the word he used.
John Kawaja, and has always impressed me at this level. The talk about the weight, what they attempt to do. Everything is with a purpose, everything is with a designation, everything is really taken to chance.
They lost it. It just, it picked something for sure, because it, we're trying to hear the comments, but it had to pick something.
Hey, it's too bad, and Vic makes a good point. Everything they do has a purpose, trying to set up the end, and that one was lost probably on a piece of debris. That gives Wayne Middaugh now a great chance. And the skips have to do a lot of thinking so far ahead about the positioning of these stones. Graham now going to make a play, black onto yellow, maybe get rid of both yellows.
Make the double here, raise double. There's the one, there it is.
Oh, I love his shot.
That was lined up all the way, and so that's why Ed was trying to move those rocks around.
Same shot.
Already.
I know.
Yeah, trying to get to this one?
Yeah.
Half? Yeah.
John Kawaja?
Yep, hard.
Well, marketing manager for Adidas.
Wow.
And it's fair to say he has earned his stripes throughout his curling career.
Right on.
It's fair for you to say.
Thank you.
Yep.
Ha! Nice shot. Thing that you don't want to forget about this particular game, you're not just talking about $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000. You're talking 30s and 40s and a trip back next year.
I know it's dead straight with the
So you're talking big bread, pal, I'll tell you. If you win this, you come back next year.
Yep.
36-5. total prize money available in the game. The winner picks up, though, that added bonus of $11,000. In the semifinals, Werenich, $15,000. Middaugh picked up $15,250.
Well, wait,
Wayne. Well, if you know, you roll a little further that way, it's tough, huh?
In turn with good weight. Here he comes again.
Whoa.
The margin for error here is very, very small.
Oh, goodness. I think on those interns, he's just putting them out a tiny bit, and he makes such a big difference. They just got by the guard.
Doubles there now, though.
I can make a rock go straight.
Werenich has to score two. He could remove this stone, but he can get in behind the guard with the intern draw, set up the possibility of scoring a deuce.
Yeah, I was a guy in the air, hoping I was shifting the weight of the earth.
Edge of the four.
Edge of the 4 foot to get to there.
Mike?
Okay. Wayne is either putting those out a little bit, Linda, or he's just taking too much ice, one or the other. Because there's no question, when you throw that kind of weight, it is running absolutely dead straight. It is not working hardly at all.
Ed Werenich, this is his first, and for the first time in the game, he has last rock, so he'll look to score his two.
The other nice thing for Ed is the two black stones belonging to Wayne Middaugh in the house are not set up that well for a double raise to the 4 foot area.
Wow.
So this come around sets up the potential for the skin.
Wow. Lot of room. Wow.
How heavy is it?
Rub.
Yep. Yep. Quiet.
Try to rub off the black one.
Nothing. Yep. Nothing.
Oh, I keep sleeping.
Slides back eight.
Jeez.
You like that?
If I hadn't been heavy, it'd have been fine, eh?
I believe it sits behind there. Let me just go here.
Oh, this way. I just see if we got a chance to steal one if I play that. Or is he just going to draw to here for his one?
What do you think? I can even draw down and just bump it to here.
Bump it right out. I can bump it right out from here.
You don't have to.
Wow, just because then he's got to throw a cool draw.
Yeah.
Can you see any of it?
Okay. Hack?
Yeah.
If it runs, we still might end up getting shot. I don't think it will, but.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Hair more. Bump it right out.
The first thing they talked about was coming down and hitting this one here.
Yeah, maybe hair more.
Back onto this one and moving this rock here up into this area here and trying to steal a point. They've now decided, I'll just take that off the screen, to come down to this one here, just sitting on top of it. If it happens to run straight, you might clip that one.
He's actually going to play weight, Ray. What he's concerned about drawing is he'll leave an easy carryover. I mentioned the double raise angle wasn't perfect, so he's going to try and hit and flop with this one, get out of there and not let Ed draw down to it.
And look at the flop in behind cover, too. So now a piece of the four.
You leave the cold draw for the 1 point. And he was a little heavy last time, that's all.
Yeah, I know. But I knew it would curl there.
What's that?
Wayne Middaugh won 4 times on the World Curling Tour this season.
That conversation, Wayne says, it's not a big hole, you know. That's when you're trying to talk yourself into a steal here.
Right.
It's
this
not
is a tough
hole.
Shot for Wayne.
Yeah, that's a big shot.
Final stone for Ed Werenich as he tries to get a full eight and piece of the four better to force the carryover of $3,000 here in the fourth.
Oh, it caught something.
Similar to what happened to John Kawaja. And so like that, it will be the steal for Wayne Middaugh of $3,000. And he now has jumped into the lead after four.
Handprints.
What's that?
Handprints.
This is it for the game.
Rob Clark, this is your right guard sports moment.
No matter how hard you push it, you don't have to sweat it. Not with the long-lasting protection of Right Guard Sports Stick. Even under the most grueling conditions, Right Guard Sports Stick works to keep you dry, confident, and odor-free. The continuous action formula of Right Guard Sports Stick.
Rob? Come on, we're late.
Right Guard Sports Stick, right there when you need it.
It's as old as the wheel. Man seeks rental cars that are not only nice, but of course nearby. That's why Thrifty made them so handy. With car rentals right at the airport or right in the neighborhood.
And remember, each time you rent from Thrifty Car Rental, you'll earn 500 Canadian Plus points.
Your neighborhood Thrifty Car Rental, historically known for low rates.
When Marie-Antoinette said, "Let them eat cake," did she mean McCain deep and delicious cake with a see-through dome that seals in the rich, moist flavor? So you can reseal it and put it back in the freezer until you just have to have another rich, moist piece. Try McCain deep and delicious cake with the resealable flavor of dome. You can let them eat cake again and again.
Welcome back to the 1995 McCain TSN Skins game from the Mayflower Curling Club in Halifax. Pleased to say we'll be in Sault Ste. Marie. Mark Mackey is the chairman of the organizing committee. It's going to be nice to go back to the Sioux because the last time our TSN curling crew was there was 1990 for the Labatt Brier.
That's right. We had what we thought a fairly successful Brier. And it helped boost curling in Sault Ste. Marie very much so. And for that reason, we wanted to continue bringing championships to the Sioux.
Well, and that's great. As we said, we look forward to going back to it. What was it? Was it that fact alone that interested you in the McCain TSN Skins game?
It was a big factor. We're trying to promote the sport in our community. And big events like this certainly help attract people to the sport.
Well, Mark, we look forward to returning to Sault Ste. Marie next year and wish you and your volunteers all the best, and we'll see you in 1996 in Sault Ste. Marie.
Thank you very much.
Here, that ain't bad either.
The fifth end is just underway. And now we're playing for $3,500. The steal of $3,000 has put Wayne Middaugh on top, $6,000 to $5,000.
He needs it.
Got a lot of room.
Well, that was too bad because Eddie threw it pretty well, and he definitely had lots of weight,
short, leave it short.
And it just caught something and picked, and that's a big swing of three, you know, of money.
Yep.
$3,000 over a little debris on the ice surface, or a flat or dead spot, one or the other.
Here are the first, the early numbers on the leads. And there's that battle. You thought maybe Neil Harrison might have the advantage on his experience against Scott Bailey.
Well, it's obvious by the numbers, they're both very good players.
Yeah.
Scott played very well. He set a lot of those first stones just short of the rings. That's always a great
good
position.
It's coming.
Especially when you're going for the steal.
Here it comes, going sideways.
He did the same thing yesterday.
You made mention of it yesterday, Linda,
that he really did get his stones in great positions. And when you're playing for a skip that likes to maneuver things from the front of the house or the side of the rings like Wayne does, that's it's pretty important.
We talk about positioning the stones short of the rings, then you can bump them up, and here's a nice looking raise.
Right here.
Question from Marshall Crocker wants to know if a team runs out of time but still has a timeout left, what's the ruling?
Well, it's interesting. You can't let your time clock run out of time. You can call a timeout prior to that happening with a few seconds left. And in this case, at the Skins game, you can play through your timeout. You can throw your stone as the timeout 1 minute is running. At a national event, you are not permitted to do that. As soon as you're finished your discussion or whatever, time's back in and you can't play through that timeout. So you have to leave a little more time
just
on your time clock at a national event. But also, as long as you've let go of the stone, it's okay. You
Once
can let it go
the
down
yellow,
the ice
really
and the time can run out.
Close. Here it comes. Here it comes.
Yep. Boy, this really walks
it's
across
very,
here.
Very hard. Shot. Good. Perfect.
Ooh. Good shot. It is right. You see that come across? Unbelievable. And that's what we call finish. That's
Is there any of them sticking out?
No, there isn't. We can tell you. No, Eddie, yeah, there's, yeah. there's nothing sticking out there.
Yeah. You're going to have to get rid
of the
front.
The attraction is on the shot.
So we watch Pat Perreault here. Gary Kerbis of Vernon, B.C., and Scott Simon of Red Deer wanted to know about what they both called in, seemingly hog line violations.
Whoa, whoa.
Well, Linda, here we, unlike a CCA event, there are no... people to call violations and camera angles that don't do justice to the hog lines either. And the fellows are playing a gentlemanly game here.
It's the same in the WCT. That
Just
rules
board.
The same way the players police themselves.
Chess board.
Pat wasn't playing, we thought, as well as he could yesterday, but look at those great numbers today.
That would be the bay board.
Yeah, it would be. Thunder bay board.
A little more weight than they expected when they talked about board weight there.
Hit and roll there, I guess. All right, you can do that. Is there enough room?
Yeah.
Okay.
I ain't sure either turn.
Just quietly. Tap and roll.
Wop. Should be lots.
Wop.
Should be Wop. Lots of weight.
Ah! Heavy?
Yeah. Yep.
Stay with it. Yep. Yeah!
He's going for the split now, or a little rub, trying to get some action.
Yeah! Oh, there it is here.
No, it is,
roll.
Bye.
Yep. Yep.
It looked like it was hanging so long, I thought they were going for plan B, but it worked out fine.
Ah, fooled you just a little bit, did it?
Fooled me completely, Vic. Didn't bump at the angle and didn't get enough of a roll.
Just
so it is available. And you'd think Graham McCarroll might make this looking at those numbers.
Clean.
He should have a little touch of the flu every
close,
time he
close.
Plays.
Close.
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 Close. Curl it. Smidge it.
Don't touch it. Yep. Go hard, Pep.
Yep, Pep.
Go.
Yep.
Good shot.
A little smidge at the end. Ducks a corner behind the guard.
Do you want to hit it and roll here, or you want to just tap it back? Breaks so hard, it's hard to figure out the...
I tap it back.
I just play that.
Tap it back, yeah.
Just touch it back, keep it in play. Eddie always trying to set up the two. Play the same way the last end. He just moved for two and actually threw a good shot with his last rock, and it just picked, as we mentioned, picked something.
Yep.
John Kowalczyk.
Go for line.
Hurry.
Hard.
Hard.
This is an example of how you don't worry about how many opponent stones are in the rings. You continue to go for setting up two and have last rock. He's just trying to reposition them.
Yeah, keep the angle.
It's a little light, but the angle's pretty good. Later, they can maybe tap it up.
Well, a little bit more weight than that.
Here.
Wayne will try and close the end off now by playing the guard.
Center line.
Center line is fine.
Linda Ray, look at that. There's almost 4 minutes difference in terms of play time. Ed Werenich using 4 minutes more already than Wayne Middaugh.
Right,
but when you see so many rocks in play, you're bound to use every minute of that 67 plus the timeouts.
And Wayne throws so many fast rocks, they come down quick.
Sit. No.
Wow.
No.
You don't want it too tight, otherwise you can go bang, bang. And that's the plan.
No, I think you go three quarters and roll right there.
Okay, all right.
She's already done the questions and answers.
Yep.
It's too tight. It came far too tight to the rings. It gives Joan a chance here.
Black one to yellow one to black, try and get a little bit of a roll away.
Whoa.
Right here, same shot yesterday.
Right in the tee.
What's that?
Yeah.
Well, it's interesting how these two players throw very similar, John Kawaja and Graham McCarroll. We'll take a look at John. And lift, good step. Watch them now, they stay pretty high in their deliveries in behind the stone. Back leg out with the foot turned out, which is not that common, but good and straight. Here's the other. No sidestep as compared to John. See the back leg and both high in the shoulders.
Whoa. Where's Wayne?
Very similar.
Whoa.
As we see Wayne Middaugh's stone.
No. Let
it his finish. First tier in five.
Boy, that's normal.
Sorry, boys.
That trailing foot act is a bit of a rudder, Linda.
Yeah, it can. That's why you have to be a little careful. Toeing out's fine as long as you keep nice and high and keep the shoulders square, but it can give you a little bit of trouble sometimes.
That's not good. We got to get this one now, don't we? Which turn we're going to throw?
I like the outturn.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why? Oh, yeah.
Well, lots of room.
Right there?
Yep.
Double's there. Back, catch this one on the way by.
First try, sorry.
Hurry!
Just a little adjustment as you let it go.
Hurry! Hard!
Whoa.
Catch the corner, get them both.
That was great sweeping. They held the line. It looked like maybe he was going to overcurl the shot.
Why are you hit and roll behind?
What's that?
Hit and roll behind again.
Hit and roll here, got it forced.
Hit and roll behind again, forced.
Yeah. Looks to me like the other Yellowstone is third shot.
Mm-hmm. What's his play if he knows it?
Two.
Huh?
His last shot. If I knows it, he hits it for two.
I don't know about that.
I think the black one's.
He's got a roll, maybe
shot.
A hair.
Who's third shot? Who's third
it.
Shot? We're second, man.
Are we second?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we are.
My point would be correct.
That's why it was critical where that yellow one rolled to.
Yeah, actually, the nose is good, I think. Is he going to try the thin double?
Maybe.
Well, let's roll it then.
Now here you go.
Oh,
very nice.
Graham says we are.
Which will it touch first? The black one.
Glad he's paying
attention.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
No, this is good.
Very good.
Well, he can play the thin double, but
you can do it all right.
I just designed that last night. Actually, I just had nothing to do between 12 and 5.
Whoa!
Wayne Middaugh.
Where's the way?
Clean.
Whoa!
You don't want to set up the double here because he can make the double for two.
Yep.
Okay.
Double still.
Yeah, I can't really hurt myself because I was skinning that one, eh?
Yeah.
Does the nose get us a point?
No.
Anywhere across the nose does it. I hit that pretty thin, don't I?
Yeah. Less than half, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Gotta make sure you miss that one, just kill that one.
That's probably tight ice.
That looks pretty good to me.
It'll go hard at the end.
Okay, he has to hit this pretty thin to catch this here. Come across and possibly make the double to score the 2 points. The question was, if I hit it on the nose, am I shot rock? And the answer was no. Mm. So you have to hit it on this outside for sure so you get some roll into this area here and at least get your one.
Looks like he might be able to even rub off his own and get a little roll in for that option. So a couple of chances, but the big chance is for the thin double for the skin. Yeah.
And $3,500 here in this fifth end. Staying straight, huh?
He's got to make contact.
Now across and by. And now they'll have a look. One black, says John Kawaja, which means the steal for Wayne Middaugh, $3,500 here in the fifth. The king is being rocked.
The king has a tasty pizza snack.
They call it Pizza Pockets.
The king.
Pizza Pockets.
The great pizza taste will keep you coming back. The king.
Pizza Pockets.
Pizza perfection in a crust that's baked, not fried. So there's no leaks, no mess, just taste. All taste and nothing but
McCain.
Pizza Pockets.
No leaks, no mess, just pizza perfection.
1, 2, 3, 4.
To be a hockey player, you don't have to be the best skater. But to be a hockey player, you gotta have no fear.
Have no fear, hockey fans. Rock 'em, sock 'em, 7 is here. 1 hour of the best goals, bloopers, saves, and...
hits, hits, and more hits.
And, of course, Coach's Corner. Plus, Cribs tells you how to buy the proper equipment. Don Cherry's Rock 'em, sock 'em, 7 from Quality. He stores now.
We make maple leaf wieners for Courtney, who will only eat Mr. Broccoli if he hasn't touched Mr. Gravy. We make maple leaf wieners for Tim, who says peas explode in his mouth. And for Caitlin, whose scrambled eggs must be shaped like little boats. Maple leaf wieners have a taste made especially for kids. For Kenny, who won't eat anything with sauce, and Jason, who won't eat anything without sauce, there will always be maple leaf.
Welcome back to Halifax, the Mayflower Curling Club, the 1995 McCain TSN Skins game. And after opening with the first $5,000, it's been all Wayne Middaugh. Ray is with Ed Werenich.
Eddie, this game involves a lot of elements, a lot of skill, and a lot of good luck and bad luck. And in that particular two ends in a row, kind of some bad breaks.
Yeah, we had a nice skin working in the fourth end, and we got two picks. But that's the one thing we can control. The one thing we can control is my intern in the fifth end. I just flared it a little bit. I was trying to throw a little more weight than I normally throw just to make sure that I hit the high side, and I floated out a bit, missed it by a couple inches.
Well, you also mentioned that you have to miss it on that side because a nose hit wouldn't have given you a point there.
No, I wasn't all that concerned about a nose hit, though. Like, I mean, you know, on nice conditions as good as these, you should be able to at least hit a quadrant of a rock, you know. And so I'll just have to get sharper.
Lots of ends to go, lots of money left, Ed. Good luck.
Oh, yeah, we've just begun.
Linda?
Well, Wayne, so far the story has been some big weight shots that haven't worked for both sides. Ice a little different today?
It's a little tricky, you know. It's curling a hair more, so you think when you step your weight up, it's still going to break. But I should know better. When you step your weight up, the ice doesn't curl.
Any change in plans? Fairly cautious. A lot of play to the centers again. Any change for the last five ends?
No, we'll still be going hard and hoping he has to throw more tough shots than I do. And if it works out that way, that'd be great.
We wish you the best of luck.
Thanks, Linda.
The McCain TSN Skins game. Four-time champion Ed Werenich, but he's in a battle today against Wayne Middaugh.
When Marie-Antoinette said, "Let them eat cake," did she mean McCain deep and delicious cake with a see-through dome that seals in the rich, moist flavor? So you can reseal it and put it back in the freezer until you just have to have another rich, moist piece. Try McCain Deep and Delicious Cake. With the resealable Flavor Lock Dome, you can let them eat cake again and again.
For all the curling news from across Canada, in fact, right around the world, you should subscribe to Canada's national curling magazine, The Curling News. Call toll-free 1-800-553-8003. The Curling News.
Wherever the fun is, that's where you'll find JVC. JV.
Welcome back to the Mayflower, our continuing coverage of this final, the 1995 McCain TSN Skins game. The defending champion, Ed Werenich, is here. Began play yesterday, and in a semifinal against Larry Pino from Thunder Bay, won to qualify for the final. Larry Pino got here to Halifax by winning the qualifying McCain Super Spiel in Portage La Prairie.
Nice and tight.
Kerry Burtnick qualified as the defending Labatt Canadian Brier champion. And that's the fourth team, Wayne Middaugh, qualified by winning last week a McCain Super Spiel East in Florenceville, New Brunswick. So that's how we got these four teams, and now we're down to these two.
We have a question here from Robert Popine from Thunder Bay, which is kind of relevant to this game. Graham McCarroll talked about a handprint on the ice. How could this affect the rock? I just came off the ice at the interview, and I talked to Shorty Jenkins, and yes, there is a couple of handprints out there. And what happens when you put your hand on the ice? The heat of the hand kind of melts down a little bit, and there's a little lip or a little edge that's formed. And so it's very important that you keep your brush on the ice surface. Here. If you move the brush up off the ice surface, the stone, the running surface of the stone can catch that little lip and kind of turn the stone quickly on you. There's no debris out there because they're using synthetics, so that was the actual fact in this particular game.
Scott Bailey.
Lots of room. Tons of room. Oh, just for weight. Tons of room. Oh. Oh. Get to here. Hip! Hip! Hard! Hurry hard! Come on, it's coming. Okay.
Andrew Weston from Queen's University. I wonder if he's a physics student. Wants to know, we mentioned that the black stones are a little straighter. What does that mean?
Well, all the running surfaces are different, of course, and all the stones are different. We try desperately to match them. In the case of there's a couple stones, actually in the yellow and the black, is that the running surface in some cases can be a little pitted, or the stone just runs a little straighter than another one. It doesn't react to the same pebble the same way. And as a result of that, you have to know it, that the stone is running straighter. I think the 3 and 5 and 7 stone, or 3 and 4 and 7 stone in the black handles are a little straighter. And they match them up and they get to know that. And if you don't know that, of course, and you should, then it can affect the calling and reading of the ice. But it's the running surface, the quarter inch band on the bottom of the ice of the stone that can change its reaction or action on the ice surface.
Here.
But we talked about the stones before the game, and the stones are match them up.
In fact, Linda, was it the 3 and 4 stones blacks that they were thinking were the problem stones?
And the 7 stone as well.
All three of them, and so you make sure that you understand that, and the skip knows which ones you're throwing so they can broom for it. A little bit.
Playing for $3,500 here in the sixth end, and right now it's $9,500 to $5,000. Middaugh in front of Werenich. There you see what's available still. 7 and 8, 4,000, 45 in the ninth, 10th end worth 6,000. And it will be the leading money winner.
one center line area. Wow. This one's curling though.
Yep.
Roll it.
I think that surprised him.
Very much so.
Tap it to here.
What?
Tap it to here.
Okay.
Back into there.
Clean. Line's good. Just for weight. Line's good.
Whoa.
Line.
Whoa.
It's not bad.
Not clean.
Just clean it.
Yep. Graham McCarroll bumps it up top four and behind cover.
Yeah.
That injury moved a lot more than they thought, Linda. So we'll see what happens with this one.
Yeah.
John Kawaja.
Wow.
Hold up.
He released it a little bit differently, right, put it back with his hand, a tiny bit on release. Will it come up?
Yep.
Okay. Leaves the raised stone still shot.
You want to guard it? You want to go here?
John has a very positive release anyway, but if you're going to do this, holding the handle straight and putting the turn on it late, you have to be careful not to use your fingers and push it out at all.
McCarroll was 100%. Gosh, now at 98.
Okay. Well, you replace him.
You're just going around it, though, eh?
You throw a tight guard.
Okay.
I did talk to Graham. He's actually very ill. I thought maybe he was just feeling a little under the weather. He's just curling
a remarkable game considering how badly he's feeling. Yeah, we go long. He goes right around.
They want to just tuck it around the front two stones a little bit if they can to avoid running the run back double. They can just get it tucked around the guards a little bit.
How's the weight? Rip.
Once again, they can put a lot of pressure on Eddie.
Where's the weight?
Oh.
Waymadaw's first.
No, not that tight. No.
It was John's first shot that really turned this end around.
But this one isn't taking that same movement.
No, not at all.
Curl. Do something. Yep.
Whoa.
Gives him one more chance at this double now. Can't lie too off it, but he can certainly open it up. Get rid of them both.
Yep. Linda Ray, Kathy Lowther contacted us via the internet, wanted to know if this is the first time these two teams have played this season, and surprisingly, considering all the bond spiels that they might be at together, they haven't played each other, so this is the first time. Wayne Madaw's team has been together 2 years and Ed Werenich's four. Ed Werenich's first stone. Needing to score the two to pick up the $3,500 skin here in the sixth end.
Yeah.
Wonderful shot.
Very nice shot. He left his block at the center line area. It can be pumped up. Got rid of the one off the forefoot.
And he needed to make a big shot like that.
And this one did hang for a long time, but they were patient. The sweepers stayed off it to allow the movement. Came up to the face of the first one. They actually almost let
it
go too long.
Yeah, you're right.
Got the one out that they needed out.
That guy over there. Oh, yeah. I threw that really good.
Not much.
An inch.
Yeah. Half an inch. That's not much on a rock.
Yeah. Any bit more and you would have scored.
Yeah.
Talking about his last rock, the last end.
This will give us a great idea how much swing there is with a draw from near the outside of the 8 foot. We haven't seen this in turn this wide. Wayne trying to come around and prevent the two for Werenich.
Wow. It's got lots of weight too. They dropped right off it. Picking it up again now. This is going to be wide open.
It's going sideways, Ted. It's going sideways.
Right out. And back.
I don't think it's getting any slower. It's not getting any slower.
No. Who's saying that?
What's that? Scott said he's
Werenich and Middaugh. And neither obviously would be happy with their numbers. Remember, though, Werenich had that one stone catch on him in four.
You would have had to cross the line to make your draw. We were drawing to here.
Yeah, I know, but we wouldn't. It was both perfect, wasn't it?
I think you need another inch.
I don't want to just skin off it, Johnny.
Okay.
He's going to play the tap back for two. You're just not sure of the weight out here. You just heard Wayne Middaugh. If you take out here and draw into this area here for your deuce, you've got to go out, as Linda mentioned, a little wider. So what he's going to do, I'll just clear that for you. He's going to take the less ice here and tap this rock back into the 8 foot for two.
Ed Werenich, his final stone, looking for his second point to pick up the skin. $3,500.
Stay on this now. Keep your brushes on the ice.
Well, line's good. Line's good.
Okay. Easy. All right, he's good. Hi, boy.
Yes, sir. Great shot. That's the momentum, maybe, Linda.
To pick up $3,500. And now the wrench is within a grand. That's all that's separating these two here in Halifax.
McCain has a tasty pizza snack.
They call them pizza pockets.
McCain!
Pizza pockets.
The great pizza taste will keep you coming back. McCain!
Pizza perfection in a crust that's baked, not fried. So there's no leaks, no mess. Just taste, all taste, and nothing but
McCain
Pizza Pockets.
No leaks, no mess, just pizza perfection.
Does your stomach look like this? In just a few minutes a day, it could look like this. If you start using this. Introducing the revolutionary new Abflex, the first home exercise machine that works the upper, lower, and side abdominals with one simple exercise. Thanks to its patented direct resistance design, the Abflex zeroes in on those hard-to-target abdominal muscles, so it can produce dramatic results like this in just 3 minutes a day.
4.5 inches I lost. I was 39.5, went down to 35. Boom, just like that.
Here's the Abflex guarantee. If you don't lose 3 to 6 inches and 10 pounds within 30 days, simply return the Abflex system for a full refund. The Abflex, it's the fast way to a firm, flat stomach and a slim, shapely waistline. So call now.
Have your credit card ready and call the number on your screen to order your Abflex system right now. Lose 3 to 6 inches and 10 pounds within 30 days or return the Abflex system for a full refund of your purchase price. Call now.
Yep. Well. Okay.
The seventh end is just underway, and we're playing now for $4,000. And you can see Werenich with the skin in six is within 1,000 of Wayne Middaugh. But Middaugh now with last rock, the hammer, will look to score his two. This is the Middaugh lead, Scott Bailey.
Well, let's see. If in actual fact, that momentum, that skin, Linda, works for Eddie. He really, you know, he mentioned to me on the ice, we just got to get a skin under our belt so we can get ourselves rolling again. And he got a nice one. He got, it was nice to have just a tap back for two to get it, so.
That was a mistake we don't often see from Wayne Middaugh. At least he needed to get that rock in there and force a play on it. That's that tap or draw, whatever, is not the kind of shot you're going to see Ed Werenich miss very much. So it was important for Wayne to get one in there. He didn't. Ed got the skin, so can Wayne now get it back on track?
I think we get a message from Bob Beckwith from Jasper. There's 100 centimeters of snow, and they're looking forward to seeing us next week.
So yep.
Bob, we look forward to being there.
Do I have to bring my shovel? Is that what you're suggesting?
No. Oh. Possibly your skis.
Ah. Yep. Yeah. Hard!
World Curling Tour final. Semi-finals and final next weekend from Jasper.
Hard! Come on! Behind
our... Neil Harrison, look at this.
Look at the movement in that spot. The first one by Scott Bailey over curled and tapped the guard, and that one just went sideways.
Donna Gale Mosiak wants to know how Rick Folk is doing in Swift Current. Rick doesn't play a lot of Bonspiels, but the winner of Swift Current will pick up the 24th and final spot at the World Curling Tour.
Yep.
Well, Donna. Rick Folk was a winner in the semi and the quarterfinal, so he's on to the final four. Look at this. Brad Height, Greg Anholt. Last week, remember, we saw them in Saskatoon. Eugene Ritzik loses to Dwayne Edwards, and John Bubbs, former Skins participant, is a winner in 11 over Grant McGrath. So they're down to final four in Swift Current, and again, the winner of that, Bonspiel, gets the 24th and final place in Jasper.
I know, you want to try a hack?
How about you just freeze the inside corner?
Scott Bailey's last stone is the black one in the corner of the forefoot. He came down to the yellow stone belonging to Ed Werenich, but tapped and rolled open. So Ed was talking about whether they would try and tap it out. Looks to me like they're just coming down to draw in front of it.
Just kind of catch it, I think, a little bit on the center line side on the inside.
Right
up. Mine went back.
He's coming back.
Pat Perot.
Just freeze to the face, it's fine.
This is as wide as any stone we've seen today.
Well, they went wider because they saw all the other ones curl so much, but the movement is late. That's why they have to wait on the sweeping as well and get it to come over before the line is right.
Like this? Normal? Normal or firm? Just firm board. Same shot we were throwing down here earlier.
Ian Tedley. $4,000. The skin here in seven. 36-5 available in this game.
Maybe more weight than he wanted.
Okay.
Right there? I think you got it.
I guess. Should be lots.
Yeah.
In what we call traditional curling, you might see Ed make a play on the black one that's in the house. He could try a raise or a tap. This is another case where in skins play, you're working to set the end up for your skip for the possible steal or with last rock, the two.
No, Diane.
They wanted that one to corner it, sit in front of it.
Jesus, that thing stopped.
She had overlapped a little bit, but it looked like it was never going to stop.
Walked over and stopped dead. You heard John's quad just comment. Did that ever stop?
Just hack, Ted. Just hack. So this one only goes here. There's room to do that?
Yeah.
Cap, just hack. Clean.
Ian Tedley.
Clean it. How's the weight?
Weight's good.
Clean it.
Whoa.
Clean it.
Whoa.
Lots of rotation, very positive rotation, and perfect hack weight.
That's fine.
What are we lying?
Two, I think.
Two yellow?
Yeah, we're lying two.
Well, we could tell you.
Throw the guard?
Yeah, I think so. Eddie? He's got to make sure we guard the right side of that shot rock. Otherwise, he can make a double.
Oh, yeah. I better use this turn then.
Okay.
Tough way to make it.
Whoa.
Yep, clean
off.
It.
Off.
Heavy?
Lots.
Whoa.
Right off.
Stay with it. How heavy?
Whoa.
Whoa. Get ready.
Whoa!
They want this to get to center line.
Cross the face. Yep.
Ed Werenich put his brush down in the middle of the eight.
And they had to come in at it with that turn because the other turn it would either cross too much
hair
or hang out too much.
Is better. This is perfect.
Okay.
Which way? You want out or in?
It's too tight to the ring, Linda. They want the guard, they wanted it longer than that. This makes the raise back too easy.
Whoa! 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 Whoa!
No!
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 Oh, you're gonna get it anyways.
Yep.
No. Sit.
Shoot.
Graham was either a little outside or extra weight. It didn't curl enough. It did clean house a little bit, opened up the front.
I thought it'd come up a bit.
Right there, make the double, punch this one in here. Which turn do you want to use?
Out turn.
It's better with the out, I guess.
Just hit this a little bit on the outside. It'll move that one that way. Yeah. The stone you strike will go there, and it may even move this one over a bit.
Yep.
Yeah! Graham McCarroll's comment relates to something you found out from Wayne Middaugh. Any extra weight, and it doesn't come up, doesn't finish for you.
Very tricky, very little margin for error, as we said. Got to hit it on the center line side.
Look at that. John Kawaja.
Just wanted to roll over a little bit more, however. They may be lined up.
Rolls another 3 inches.
Just yeah, that's right.
Can you see any of this with the out turn?
Half.
Normal.
I don't think these are lined up to catch that one.
Clean it. Yep.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa. Whoa. Ah.
Sometimes you get a real shock when you hit these stones and how they come off the window.
Yep.
There's the roll and you're right, Ray. They weren't lined up.
But you saw them, they were planning the roll with the black rock. Now they can come in with the intern draw, or if needed, that black rock can be promoted onto shot stone. So again, opening up the options and forcing Ed Werenich to decide, what do I protect?
No slower.
Okay. It's probably pretty tight ice too, though.
No, this is plenty ice.
you gotta love the conversation. Playing the guard.
That's Wayne Middaugh, of course, trying to score the two in this end to pick up the $4,000.
No slower, he said, so it's not heavier out here.
Wolf a line. Way up there. Clean.
Wow.
Yep. Come on.
Trying to sweep it to catch the curl. So far, it hasn't found the movement in the ice.
Hard. Come on. Close that hole. Hard. Right up.
Ed thought at first that wasn't enough ice. John said it's plenty, and as it turned out, the rock didn't curl enough, so maybe it was too much ice.
Board weight, July 2. You can see almost it all.
Board. I don't think nothing's really gone nuts out in the white, eh? Like even the dry through last day.
Once you get out in the white, what Wayne's referring to, when you get out in that white area, it just it stays out there sometime.
You can see Wayne rushing a little bit. He's a little short on time, perhaps, but even more so for the Werenich team. They're going to be picking up the pace a bit here.
Hard! Right up! Come on, harder!
Three!
Whoa!
Through. And they're lying too.
That's a great shot, boy.
Good boys. Scrubbing.
Good scrubbing. Good brushing is right.
My board.
Yeah, no. Well, you're a little narrow, but I knew you were coming at me pretty good, so I wasn't unhappy.
That was my board weight, he said. That's different than everybody else's board weight.
Pardon?
Tightness. You got your watch?
Yeah. Please.
Of course. Can't forget the courtesy.
Well, this is a big draw. Wayne wants to find out what the weight is like, so he's getting a time on it. For Ed Werenich, he wants to make sure he gets it tucked a little behind the guard and tries to take away this end, maybe even have a chance for a steal.
He wants this behind the guard so he can take away the extra point.
Room.
Force Wayne to.
Lots of room.
Wayne! Clean.
It's got to start to come.
Ready? Yep.
No. Here it comes now.
Whoa.
Only if you have to.
Wolf line.
Yep.
Yep, going now.
Yep. Whoa.
Whoa, whoa. Easy, easy, easy. Easy.
Whoa.
That's beauty.
First shot, top four. Can Middaugh get there, or will he come off one of his own?
It's a couple of ways to get at it, but again, we're going back to the choice. Draw for the carryover, a big shot for the two.
What's same that? Weight, same shot?
So a little more weight.
Why are you running the top one back then?
I think the top one running back's tougher, isn't it? Why'd I have to throw peel to run the top one back? Six and one half to the other.
You hit it in the nose, you still get it. You can probably still throw this one with intern even and still get hit.
Yeah, that's tough going across the line. That's so tough going across the line.
You figure?
Well, looking at
runs and
looking
runs and runs.
Maybe
runs
running this one back here.
It's the same shot that you guys were throwing down here, though.
Or come right off of this one here, as Vic suggests.
I don't care. I don't mind that one either.
Yeah, but I hit what I can see is not good enough. The rocks are too dead. Run her back. Feel.
Mm. There's your decision.
Where do you want me to hit it?
Just want it just a hair on the broom side.
Rocks are dead, Linda. What's he mean?
We did talk about a little bit. When the ice is lively, it seems that the rocks will roll very easily. Here they don't do that, and so you need to catch a different portion of the stone in order to get the roll you want. And I think the raiseback in this case is the easier shot anyways.
I think you're better to reference it to the ice as opposed to the rocks themselves, though.
Yes.
Yep.
Yep.
The ice surface.
Hard.
Not to confuse everybody out there.
Run it straight back. No.
Isn't it interesting that the three of the big weight shots that he's
made, hasn't been able to
he's
make.
Made some nice clean shots, but.
Yeah. Steele, Werenich picks up the 4,000. And he moves in front, and he's getting closer to $200,000 in career skins winnings. Wayne Middaugh. No, he didn't make it.
The new Sony Handycam Vision. Clearly the latest in video cameras. With a built-in LCD screen for picture-perfect playback. There's a built-in speaker too, so you can capture every precious moment, every precious memory.
For more information, call 1-800-394-8893 or visit your Blockbuster Video or in Quebec, Le Club International.
When two-time world champion Ed Werenich started using the hammer, people laughed.
Hey, yeah, it looks like a toy.
Last year, Ed's team was the leading money winner on the Pro Tour. Now who's laughing? When Ed Werenich first used the hammer, people laughed. World champion Russ Howard is the winningest skip in Breyer history and Ed's number one rival. Russ has chosen the hammer. Now who's laughing? For more information about the hammer with quick change faceplates, call 1-800-567-7757.
Does your stomach look like this? In just a few minutes a day, it could look like this. If you start using this. Introducing the revolutionary new Abflex, the first home exercise machine that works the upper, lower, and side abdominals with one simple exercise. Thanks to its patented direct resistance design, the Abflex zeroes in on those hard-to-target abdominal muscles, so it can produce dramatic results like this in just 3 minutes a day.
4.5 inches I lost. I was 39 and a half, went down to 35. Boom, just like that.
Here's the Abflex guarantee. If you don't lose 3 to 6 inches and 10 pounds within 30 days, simply return the Abflex system for a full refund. The Abflex, it's the fast way to a firm, flat stomach and a slim, shapely waistline. So call now.
Have your credit card ready and call the number on your screen to order your Abflex system right now. Lose 3 to 6 inches and 10 pounds within 30 days or return the Abflex system for a full refund of your purchase price. Call now.
Armacain key shot of that seventh, and you're right. He hasn't been able to make the shots that you would think he can, Linda, and those are the big ones.
And a couple of times they've run too straight. In this case, he needed it to go straighter to make the proper raise. Doesn't do it and gives up the steal.
Gives up the steal of $4,000 in the seventh, and Ed Werenich moves in front. So we'll go now to the eighth again, playing for 4,000. Once again, Wayne Middaugh with Last Rock will try to score his two. Rick Lawrence on the internet wanted to know how much prize money has been played for in this the first 9 years of the skins game. Well, by my addition,
Hold everything, please. We don't want to use your addition. We know how it goes.
Yeah, that's right. $494,000, and now this year, $85,000 total prize money, so now well over $500,000.
Just check that, will you, Linda?
Yeah. And I should just tell anybody at Revenue Canada, I do not do my own taxes. So you don't have to worry about the addition. Scott Bailey.
Line's good. Oh, through. Line's good. Yep. Hard! Hurry! Room. It'll finish, though. It'll finish.
Whoa.
Get over.
Middaugh once again needs the 2 points to pick up the money.
Shot.
Okay. And it's big bread now.
Pardon?
Just their luck. How do you get the answer? To our Air Canada brain teaser, we want to know who curled 91% in a Canadian junior final, then lost to Jim Sullivan of New Brunswick.
Craig Cochin, maybe?
I don't think so. I'm not sure who it is.
It was Wayne Middaugh when they played in Prince Albert, Canadian junior that year.
Yep.
Peter Corner
Hard.
Was the skip, I Come think, on. Of that team, that Ontario team.
I went by all day. Sorry, Harry.
So the sweeping call is what they're referring to. That was by all day, you heard
right
it. You say all you had to do is sweep it.
Top 12. You can actually, if you come right in, you want to do that? Tap it. Yeah. If it comes right in, that's fine.
Back 4 weeks?
Yep. Clean it. Line's good. Tight, if anything. How's the weight?
Good.
Clean it. Yep. Hard.
Scott Bailey.
Sweeping it for line because they're so worried about this spot now. Several of them have really snapped.
Whoa. How's the weight?
Whoa. Yep. Good shot, Scott.
Ed Werenich. His time 17 and ticking down. 21 minutes remaining for Wayne Middaugh, which means that Ed Werenich is going to be very tight, Linda, although both teams still have their 3 1-minute timeouts remaining.
And we did mention earlier you can play through the timeout, so in this case it is like adding 3 minutes back on your time clock, but it does mean you're always thinking about that and rushing a bit, and you hate to be doing that when the big cash is on the line.
Come on!
We're going the other way.
Come on!
Good shot.
A rock in position to be maneuvered. That's why it's played there. At this point, Middaugh is lying to.
Go here.
But he has to worry a little bit about that yellow stone that was just placed there.
I don't mind that.
He's going to play the out turn draw into this area here.
Line's good.
Interesting.
Where's the weight? Line's
gonna leave
tight.
The tap back there, Linda.
Yep. Hard! Hurry!
Just for line.
Whoa. Yep! Hard!
Hurry. It's perfect. Come on, go.
I want to get it by that other black one.
Go harder.
Great shot, Ted.
That is a lovely shot. That really is.
What's it prevent Eddie from doing now, Werenich?
Tap that up.
Well, it closes off the other side of the ice, too. It's also the third rock in there. He's going to tap this one up. This can come across the face, and he can tap it back to the shot stone.
They'd also like the shooter to sit there because they're hoping to keep blocking the center line area and keep promoting their rocks up, eventually going for the steal.
Pat Perreault.
Come on, hurry!
This one made a huge move. Coming across the face is going to come across too much, Linda.
either a little light or it is a particular spot in the ice that really is grabbing those rocks.
A little more weight, though. I think you needed on that, too, don't you? You're sitting at home and you're watching this. You certainly say to yourself, well, the black really is in good position here, but it's those two yellow stones that Wayne's concerned
about.
Tap
it. Guard it.
Guard it is a possibility. Tap it was another possibility.
Timeout. So there's the first of the three for Wayne Middaugh.
He's going to try and tap this.
And Werenich now. Very close to $200,000. Wayne Middaugh has moved up to fourth with his money's won.
David Smith from Scotland, not the David Smith from Manitoba.
Even if you move it here, it's not awful. That's not bad. I think you gotta go here.
Okay.
Right here, Ted. You move it a hair, it's not awful, but that's perfect.
Well, you heard Wayne say they're going to play this for sure no matter what we do on this side of the sheet. So let's come down. I'll just clear it for a moment. And even if you move this a little bit here, tap this back and take away the angle for the reds.
Yeah, I'd consider myself fortunate they didn't make a good one with the last opportunity, and I'd try and take it away now for sure.
So you like it both in, huh?
It's got a curl.
Here it comes now. No, it just rubbed.
Bounce off.
Not bad.
That's all right.
Off one, then the other.
There's lots of movement in here.
Run that into that and try and blast two of them out.
Okay.
That brings a chuckle from the crowd.
Let's go.
Just blast away.
Just off the nose.
Let's go. Yeah. We haven't got much time. The clock now a factor.
Right off.
John Kawaja.
Hit it.
Boy.
And that is the one thing I mentioned about the time clock running down. I think there's enough time, but when you have that in your head, I think John rushed, and I don't think he threw it as well as he could.
That's not good.
All he's got now is this. That's all he's got. We can guard that. Okay.
And one more guard, Ned Wernick's in trouble. Wayne Middaugh has this end set up very nicely.
That's when we use the big rock.
Those are nice when you need a guard.
Dig in, get the big rock.
Right here. Right there. Line's
right
good.
Brush.
With last
Line's
rock,
good.
Needing
Line's
to good. Score two right to pick brush. Up Whoa, the $4,000 skin.
It. Just clean.
Just careful. Just clean it.
Werenich with a just lead of $3,000
right
as we play the eighth.
Hurry!
Yep, hurry!
Hard!
Shot, Graham. Graham's had a great game.
Yeah.
Got across the face of hair.
Yeah.
Run the front yellow one back. The long guard.
Wow. Right off. Never
wow, right off.
That's like hurry up
John.
Offense right now for Team Werenich.
How could you throw that thing wide? God.
Yeah, John mad at himself. I think he did rush himself on both those shots. You got to play quick, but you get away from your own rhythm
sometimes.
You
sit on the corner here.
As long as you're ready in the hack, there's enough time in the clock to actually execute the shots.
Hey?
We make fun about big rocks and little rocks, but years ago when, well, I'll take you way back, Linda. But we really had played in country bonspiels and small bonspiels where they did, the rocks were not always the same size. There were big ones and small ones. And
clean it.
We used to have a lot of fun with the fact that we would save those big ones for guards and go through the ports with the small ones. And
clean
really,
it.
That's a fact.
Yep.
Now, I don't go back as far as the time when you had your own rocks.
You didn't travel with your own,
no.
Did you? No.
Okay.
No, it's got tons of weight. Oh.
Bring in the big rock.
I gotta move this one an inch.
Yeah, did he?
That's all right.
Do himself more harm here by coming that deep.
I do have to run that in. I just cut him down to lie one right now. Yeah.
Well, you don't have to be Einstein to realize that Werenich is certainly in trouble, and all he's really got is this run back here onto this stone here and removing this one, and they'll only be lying one. The yellow stone will stay there.
Then is it fair to say you, if you're Team Werenich, you don't want your skip playing this kind of shot? This is not Eddie's shot, is it?
No, John's the kind of guy, the cleanup hitter, eh?
So and he's really let them down, and he knows it. He let them down this end. He had the chance to make the big shot for a skip.
Werenich's first.
Yep.
Well, yep.
Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa.
Hard.
All right.
Whoa. Yep.
Whoa.
Wow.
Whoa. 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 Curl.
Screwed that one up, too.
John's really mad at himself because he called that one wrong, too.
What does he got now?
Across the face slightly, and it looked like it was going to. Right?
Wayne is down a few dollars here, but he's got a great chance for the two and the skin this end.
Why don't you go here?
He gets through and he goes, I think we keep it as open as we can.
Okay.
Same shot you threw. You want to try to just move that?
Yeah, okay.
24 and a half?
Yeah.
Well, that's why I say keep it as open as I can to give me some rocks to bang around.
So he's going to come in and tap it back, Linda,
just
I think.
Just move that left one 2-3 inches.
He was worried about protecting and giving it a chance to get in there somehow and take away this end. So he's saying, let's go back a little bit to traditional curling. When you have last rock, you try and keep it a little open and leave yourself the chance for two with last stone.
Rip, whoa.
Line's good. Line's good. Yep. Yep, for line.
Rip.
Hard for
from
line.
Hogline to hogline, it should be about 14 to 15 seconds for the perfect draw to tap shot.
Nose. T-line.
Whoa.
That'll have lots of weight on it.
Whoa.
Yep.
Bring him. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Well, Swanson of Vancouver, Ray wants to notice. I noticed that Ed Werenich drops his shoulder on his delivery side. Is that good form?
Eddie Werenich isn't great good form at the best of times, okay? But all his fundamentals are pretty strong, and he kind of throws off that left shoulder a little bit and gets away with it. In answer to the question, I think we're trying to stay as square as possible.
The spot has some curl to it.
There are lots of little things that people will do that they get away with.
Yeah, you can equate it with golf swings like Lee Trevino or somebody like that, who make what they use. They do the best with it.
And for years, the best golf swing, the best striker of the ball has been Mo Norman. And you know how he swings at it. And
right out.
Ed Werenich.
Trying to come in off a side one. And from the body language, you can tell this one's not coming in.
Okay.
And that's it.
Not even waiting. Give the $4,000 skin to Wayne Middaugh in eight. And that $4,000 will jump him into the lead. 13,500, and again, we're separated by just 1,000 here in Halifax.
Presenting the Dremel Multi Pro. You cut, Dremel cuts. You sharpen, Dremel sharpens. You polish, Dremel polishes. You drill, Dremel drills. You clean, Dremel cleans. You sand, Dremel sands. You grind, Dremel grinds. You hammer. Did I mention we cut? The Dremel Multi-Pro. With up to 30,000 RPM, it has the speed you need to power through hundreds of jobs.
No one should be left off your Christmas list. Especially when Bonnie Raitt has a new live double album, Road Tested, featuring the Bryan Adams duet, Rocksteady. 22 tracks, her greatest hits, 6 new songs, and a few good friends. Get road tested with Bonnie Raitt, or you could get them some more socks.
The competitors for the 1995 McCain TSN Skins Game were flown courtesy of Air Canada. Air Canada, welcome to our world. Clothing is provided by Adidas, the brand with 3 stripes. While in Nova Scotia, the teams are the guests of the beautiful Country Inn and Suites in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia. So $1,000 separates Wayne Middaugh and Ed Werenich as we go to the ninth end of play, and now $4,500 is the skin.
And Neil Harrison must be just wondering, when is Scott Bailey going to miss one of those first stones again, positioned right in front of the house in that lovely spot that you just wait for with the free guard zone rule, and it's hard to come around it.
That 10 inch to 2 inch to 10 inch area that dictates curving now in the free guard zone game.
So Neil made the come around, but because that rock is so close, it's hard for your rock to stay in front of the tee line and be buried. That's a little too deep. It allows Scott to come down to that stone, biting the button.
And Ed Werenich has the hammer here in nine.
This is exciting when you look at the money, Vic, because it's coming right down to the wire, boy.
We've got $10,500 remaining in the final two ends. 45 now, 6,000 in 10.
Yep, hard!
And let's not forget that the winner comes back next year.
And the bonus.
And the bonus.
So there's two bonuses, 11 grand right now and the bonus of coming back. This, eh?
Yellow pipe.
You see those percentages, Linda. James Morgan of Montreal wanted to know how they're calculated.
Yeah, it's very interesting. It's out of four. If you make the shot that the skip indicates you should be making, that's 4 to 4. That's 100% on the one shot. And obviously all the shots during the game are totaled and the percentage is made. It's a little subjective to decide, for example, is this exactly where that yellow stone should have stopped? Is it 4 to 4, 3 out of 4, whatever? But they're a very good indication of how many shots have been made.
There are varying systems too. There's all kinds of different scoring systems. Some systems that will encompass the degree of difficulty for the shot, and there's bonus systems where you can get a bonus for a particular shot. But
line's good. Just for weight.
It's a 4-point system.
Hooray! Hard!
There's one particular place on this intern, and it looks like it's definitely coming off a hill. You have no chance of getting around the guard once it starts. They managed to do a little tap there. We're hoping to get by that rock.
They've got double tap, and you have a pocket a mile wide.
Not much to choose between the seconds either. Of course, the one percentage point separating them as well.
It's an interesting shot. He's going to try and hit it, his own stone, the yellow stone, which is the third shot rock, coming into view in a few moments, and just move it over a little bit, reposition it, Linda. You see the yellow stone, the third shot rock? He wants to just catch that on the corner. Remember now he has to just wants to catch it, move it over a wee bit, put it in a different position.
All right.
So busy talking.
Well, an event such as the McCain TSN Skins game isn't or doesn't happen without volunteers. Congratulations to Judy McLeod, the chairperson of this year's organizing committee, and her group of volunteers. And we thank them very much for their hospitality here at the Mayflower.
Yeah, they've been fantastic. Just every little thing you wanted, they got for you. So it's just been a wonderful, wonderful weekend.
Clean it.
And we do. We thank you very much. Some kind of hospitality.
Ian Tetley.
Look at this come.
And look at it. Walk over and sit for shot.
Well, that's kind of a bad break green, because that's a beautiful stone. It just went a little too far. They had to brush it to get it by. Linda mentioned earlier in this end, actually, that when they start to break with that intern, that's the one spot they just come down there like rockets and come across.
Yep, all right.
And again, that brush by the brush is being held right in the middle of the eight. Linda.
It's got lots of movement.
They're going to have to go on this because it's really going to break.
John Kawaja, Neil Harrison.
I wouldn't be letting up on it, that's for sure.
Look at this. Tap, and now Werenich looking to score two, flies two.
Well, it was a great shot, but we start to think about Ed Werenich needs the two for the spin, and that forefoot is getting very closed. Okay. If Wayne Middaugh can get a stone in there, maybe tap back the yellow one, it's then going to be very difficult for Ed to get two into the button.
You want to talk about pressure, and you talked about it in your opening comments, Linda. This is when it starts to really gather. Obviously, the money is on the line, big money on the line here, and the game on the line.
It's on a different planet.
It's a different planet. It's staying right out there.
Let it die. Let it dig. Let it dig.
Now, look at this.
Bounce it.
But the added weight, huh?
Okay.
Or was it a different line?
No, the weight looked pretty close to me, but they'll just come in now. This next shot by John Kawaji is a golden opportunity.
Where do you go with this?
Right into the pocket yourself. You just put three right around the butt.
Room.
Graham McCarroll Stone just sat right out there, Linda.
Go then.
To sweep it then.
All right.
This one seems to be catching the same path, the far out path. That's why they're going now for as much angle as they can by sweeping it right in. Trying to bring it up to the face of that black one.
Well, they wanted it over. Sorry.
Yeah, that just didn't take the same path they thought it would.
It seems that if you just get outside in the yellow, in the white area a little bit, it just
can still get
holds for a while.
Okay.
If you get to the yellow,
where that comes in,
the edge of the forefoot or the yellow area, a little earlier, it starts to come.
And just as John Kawaja had a great opportunity, so does Graham if he can nestle this one in. But he's going to have to get more movement on this stone.
Close.
This is sitting there, too. It should break hard right now.
Get across it anyways. Yep. Oh, what's going on?
Just a reminder, the NFL on TSN is coming up 8 p.m. Eastern time. Buffalo against San Francisco, Linda.
Go ahead, Linda.
I think 8-4 records, but I think the Niners are going to take them.
Heavy.
She's being tipped off by somebody.
Heavy.
From 3 Com Park, right, and I think the spread is 11.
Right off. It's real heavy.
49ers are favored by.
Whoa.
How heavy?
I think John's just rushing himself a little too much, Linda.
Yep.
He has just played marvelously.
Go hard.
Wayne didn't even look on the other side of the sheet now. He's coming over and he's going to try and move some rocks around. John put up that guard on the one side, so Wayne has to go to the other.
Every stone is in play.
We can see of our black.
Getting ready to play skip stones, and every one thrown is in play.
Yellow one to black, back into the pack.
Yep.
It's going to curl too much. He's trying to raise that yellow onto that black one.
Just curl. One more.
Just going to play the guard out here now. Protect the stone.
Wayne's walking around the house because he's trying to see if the guard goes up, if he's going to have a shot.
Over there, Pat.
Jeez.
$4,500 is the skin. You're in 9.
A little more, Johnny.
Move the broom out a little bit.
Yep, hard. Hard all the way.
Line's good. Clean.
Well,
I curled too much.
Just over.
Just over.
Yeah, high is good in this case.
Don't be cute.
Remember, that's what Arnold Anderson told Brad Height
on
his shot. Don't be cute on this, please. And by that they mean just don't try and get fancy with it.
Timeout.
Just over.
Second timeout for Wayne Middaugh.
Yeah. Wayne at this point doesn't really see a shot.
Because the four rock jams. The five rock goes nowhere and the four rock jams.
Hey?
Yeah, but you gotta hope that thing just spins a little.
Oh, I see. you want to spin out?
The four?
Yeah.
Well, I'd have to cross it.
Do that hair.
That's not gonna spin in. Oh, I don't know.
Can you hit this into the crotch of these ones?
I'd like to help you with the telescreator here, folks, but I can't see any angles in there.
Let it go onto here. But it's still not spinning. It's only spinning.
Nah, it's still gonna go that way.
Yeah. You gotta get one into the pocket. What's that?
This is the only one, I think.
I got across it a hair with, I think, just a heater. Hair across the face.
Yeah.
Hey?
Yeah.
Just get by that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's. I think the best I can do is nose it, Graham.
Yeah, no.
The stone here. Shoot. I think they're talking about.
Oh well.
Should have made sure I moved some rocks around on my first one. I should have made sure I moved some rocks around on my
The
first
problem
one.
Is he's trying to raise the yellow onto the black that's just biting the top of the 4 foot, thinking if he throws it hard enough, he can get that black spinning. And he's made some great shots. We've seen them, but I'm not sure if he can see enough. His last comment was he wasn't sure he could see enough to actually make this.
This is trying to move things around and then just see what happens. Oh, goodness, did it move enough?
I think he's not second shot either. The front yellow one is it. Well, it's close though. It may be.
Pretty close.
He may be.
AccuGauge.
I think it's yellow.
Johnny's kicking them off. I hope they're two.
You shouldn't be kicking them off.
Hey?
You shouldn't kick them off.
Why not? Oh, do we?
That wasn't last rock, and John Kawaj just moved the rocks off.
Well, I think we're two anyways, but.
John's in such a, he's so anxious to hurry.
Hope you got this on camera.
We have.
Find out where they were.
And that top one's got to be close too, Ben. This top black one's close too.
Well, I better put this.
We still got it, haven't we?
Better put it back. Hey? I kicked it off by mistake.
Kicked two off, didn't you?
Yeah.
Well, that's interesting.
I still think we're second shot.
This guy was right there.
Yeah, well, that was shot rock. That was.
Yeah, that was there.
The question is what happens here? I still think we got it, haven't we? You got good ice. Take a look at it.
What's that?
They're not going to say anything.
Yeah. Well, no,
I kicked it off.
Oh,
so you can put it back.
Yeah, well,
take a look.
So the rocks got spinning.
No, I kicked two of them out.
Yeah.
John thinks it was last rock.
Right there. There's
Move
another
those
one here.
Yellow ones off the back.
Film at 11.
But there?
You got to go with the replay.
Oh, it is?
There it is, there.
No, that's live.
What? Oh, it is
live. No, that's live.
The most important thing is to see for a second.
Oh, that's live.
Then it doesn't.
Of course, you can't measure the stones now because the end has not been completed to know who is second shot. The black is wide open. Ed Werenich has a good play on it for his two.
Well, this is wide open.
Well, I'm not going to throw it if I don't have to. Well, I was trying to tell you.
I know, but it's dead wide open. I guess you got to get to the inside of it. Here, why don't you throw the edge?
No, I can hit that.
That's where the stones were positioned at the conclusion of the shot before John removed those two yellow ones, back eight, back four.
Actually, I think it still has to go over here.
This one?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
That's live now.
That's live
again.
Oh, for Christ.
That's right. Now what's it?
All right, leave it there, yep. Boy. Fucking. Whoops, I said that
Why
word.
Can't I throw the intern at it?
All right.
The first second shot, why am I throwing
that? Not during that.
Hey?
Not during all that.
Now, Ed Werenich's making the point here. He believes he's second shot. Why throw it? What's he got to lose?
He's a little worried about jamming the black onto the yellow at the back and thus not getting his chip.
I couldn't have got by the top one any thinner.
There's the difference. There's the match right now.
Close.
See, now that stone has to come up just a bit, huh? They're within half a stone anyway.
Yes!
Yep, hard.
He has a choice. He could not throw it and go for the measure, but Wayne does not have to say, you get the point. He has to follow the end through.
And there he gets the inside roll for the 2 points and the $4,500 and the skin here in nine. And yeah, the rushing.
Yeah, if your second shot, kick him off and measure it. Yeah.
May as well wait until they're measured to see before you put the money in your pocket.
Like I said, you just hate to be wrong, that's all.
Well, I don't think it was, but for some reason, I think John got a little excited because he kicked
him. He was the guy who kicked him.
Yeah, so I don't think it's.
Natasha, say goodbye to Pink Bonnie.
And so Boris took aim at reducing the Energizer Bunny to one pink fur ball.
Long-lasting Energizer batteries just keep going and going.
The 1996 Ford World Curling Championships are coming to Hamilton, Ontario. Get ready to hang your hat at Cops Coliseum. For complete ticket information, call 1-800-730-CURL. That's 1-800-730-2875.
Elvis Stoiko goes for the big one and gets the jump on taste. The taste of McCain Frozen Punch. Year-round thirst-quenching taste like grape. Orange and McCain Fruit Punch. Made with real fruit juices for real fruit taste that makes McCain the punch of champions like Elvis Stoiko. Get the jump on taste. The real fruit taste of McCain Frozen Punch.
Go for McCain. Get the jump on taste.
Thanks very much for all your questions on the internet. We'll do it again. Final interactive question, though. Why is there less time allowed in skins games than a regular curling competition? That from Judy Hood in Ontario. Linda?
Well, this event is not governed by any of the other bodies that we've had in other times. World Curling Tour has their own rules, 75 minutes plus one timeout. The Canadian Curling Association at their events, it's 73 minutes plus two timeouts. Here it's 67 minutes plus three timeouts. And going into the event, you know how much time you have, and it's up to every player to be ready and make sure you use your time well.
And the reason is also we want to move the game along and keep it moving. And as Linda mentioned, Vic, it's not governed by anyone. This is a TSN event.
So it's all come down now to this final skin of $6,000. Ed Werenich sitting at $17,000, Middaugh at $13,500. Middaugh has the hammer. He'll look to score the two. And the winner will be the skins champion for 1995.
Line's good. Yep. Hard.
It's good.
Hard.
So it all comes to this end.
Lots of pressure on every player. Every rock has to be in the right position to set it up for their team.
Clean it. Right out.
Grow teeth. Whoa. Higher than a bench shot.
Shot, Pep.
Scott Bailey bites the top of the four.
Scott's nickname is Peppy, so I asked him where it came from. And Graham told me it's from Peppy the Skunk.
Oh, Peppy Le Pew.
Peppy Le Pew.
Yep.
I didn't ask any further.
All right. All right. All the way.
Neil Harrison put up the guard. Scott Bailey came around it. Hard. Neil's trying to come to the face of the black stone, setting up a possible promotion later. It's not a bad shot. Overcurled a little bit. We've seen that a couple of times. But remember the big rule. If it's behind the tee line, it can never be made better. If it's in front of the house, top 12, top 8, it can be pushed towards that button area, and that can really help your team.
Line's good. Just for weight. Line's real good. Clean it. Clean it. Room.
Wayne needs two for this skin. Just of course, if there's a carryover, if he only gets one, we see a draw to the button for that final skin.
For everything.
Right on. Yep, the bonus
of coming back. Wow. Okay.
And the players don't really like that. We've seen a couple of rocks catch something, or at least the ice affect the rock somehow, and they don't like to go down to that one rock for the final skin and all the cash. So I'm sure Wayne would love to settle it here, and Pat Perreault would like to get something going so they can have the steal and take home the cash.
Nose hit is what he wants here, right on the nose.
All right.
Exactly what we wanted.
Linda Ray, there's breaking news from Montreal and the Montreal Canadiens. Patrick Roy has been suspended by the team after an outburst yesterday after their 11-1 loss in Detroit. So the news conference to alert fans that Patrick Roy will be traded as soon as possible by the Montreal Canadiens. Of course, earlier this season, there was a lot of pressure on Roy and the entire organization after their slow start, then the coaching change, and now it's all come to a head with the suspension and possible trading of Patrick Roy. Details, the entire story from Montreal, you'll hear it on Sports Desk coming up.
Hey, Ted, great wait.
Just stayed out there a little bit. Well, what do you think, Eddie? You going to make the move on it now?
Take a timeout?
I hate to make the move early and set up a possible promotion for the opponent. They don't have a lot of time here. They're going to take a timeout.
You got to get to the inside, or that, you got to get that thing out of there.
To the inside of it.
Want to draw here?
Hitting it here.
This
will go. This will go.
I think we have to try and get to the inside of this thing.
This will go this way.
Get that onto there.
The Blackstone.
I'm not crazy with that.
Huh?
Eddie talked here.
I like where that guard is right now.
Hey?
I like where that guard is right now.
Yeah.
We got to probably try and get to the inside of the black one.
By that, he means coming this side here.
Wait, that's hard. Yeah. Yeah, this side is no good.
No. Hitting here. It'll go here. This will go out.
How about... does it make sense to try and crotch it?
We can hit... go off that one.
Yeah. You might clip the back one.
Sure, okay.
Okay.
Just try hit that hard in the middle and blow them both and leave our shooter there.
Normal?
Yeah, we can clip it off there too. Oh yeah, at least normal.
Team Werenich taking their first time out.
The dangerous rock is the black one. They looked at ways to remove it, including running the center guard on it, but they like that center guard in position in case they need it later. Yeah, I don't think you want to move that one around. I agree with them completely.
Me too.
Yeah.
It looked to me like there was enough room, as John suggested, getting to the inside of it, but Eddie didn't feel with the board weight that there would be, so.
Pat Perreault.
Yep.
The game on the line here in the 10th end and a $6,000 skin.
Yep.
He wanted the crotch, he got the crotch.
That's a good shot.
Almost.
He's gonna go bump, bump. Probably line that up. I think you go here now.
Out turn draw around the center guard to lie two. Wants it to the top of the forefoot.
Ian Tetley.
Line's good, just for weight.
This was a system that worked well for him in the eighth end. He could protect the other side of the ice where the yellow can be promoted, but instead he's coming right in.
Hard!
We need it for line.
Looking for the little rub now.
Go hard on the black! Hard! Get it past! Go!
Okay. Double there.
All right.
Wait.
John's just got lots of time. He should just take his time now.
Yeah.
Normal?
Yeah.
Wow. John Kawaja's first stone here in 10.
Hurry. Whoa.
One and across, and two.
would have liked to have removed it, but we talked about the ice not being lively before, and that was a good indication of it. Trying to hear John's comments, maybe, as he comes down to Ed.
Just get the two and roll over here is not bad. You go this way and get them all. How much can he see that?
What?
Can he see this?
Yep.
Want to try and do this? And get this one.
Yeah.
Or just straight back. I think straight back's not bad.
Catching that one.
Okay.
And try and roll over here.
The initial thought was for a big roll to try and protect the black one, but I kind of agree. Try and get one of those ones off the 4-foot area, the 8-foot area.
Harder! Hurry!
Come on! Roll!
That didn't work out very well.
No, they don't want that for sure. That center line's covered again, isn't it?
Guard?
I just don't like the fact that's black rock.
I think we got to get rid of this one.
John talked guard trying to overlap this one, but you heard Eddie's comment. I don't like this one down here.
Now there's something on my rock.
Something, he felt something under. That's. No, when you turn them, sometimes you can feel something underneath them, and that's what he was.
Hurry! Go. Hurry!
Ha! Quiet!
Okay.
He's out there, okay.
Right up. Roll it out.
Okay. Roll it right out. They don't want it there to leave Wayne anything to come in off of, so.
Sure, I think. Can't do much else.
It's looking more and more like a shootout for Big Brad.
Yeah, we haven't really mentioned that yet, that if we carry this over, and in fact it will be a draw to the button for the skin of $6,000.
Yeah,
we
didn't talk.
Comes down to this skin. Winner to pick up the bonus of $11,000 and a trip back next year to Sault Ste. Marie.
Time out.
Can't draw here, but then he's just going to glance out there.
That's number two for Werenich.
Even another shot. Guard it, he goes there, he's lice two. Can't do that. I got to hit it.
I don't like hitting it, then he's got an easy hit and roll.
Yeah, but if I don't hit it, he's got.
I like an
easy shot rock.
I think here's your shot.
No, then he just goes whack like that.
Yeah, if he does, then, well.
Then what do I want? Then I don't even have a shot.
Well, sure, you do. I mean, you can have that to there.
Go around, you almost like go.
You got to go around back here.
It follows. I think we got to hit that.
Tell you, hit it, and he makes a roll. You're not going to like the way things happen.
No, that's true, but.
At least this way, he's got to make a shot.
What John is saying is that if you hit that roll over here, you expose this one, and now he makes the hit roll.
I don't even mind it right here.
Or the other way, even.
Okay. You still got to make that thing.
I'm not sure the ice here.
John didn't like the hit.
Pretty much it was earlier.
Boy, $17,000 includes that $11,000 bonus. A huge amount of money riding on this end.
Even that amount could take care of your wardrobe.
But the pressure's on every player. The line caller, the sweepers, everybody has to be exactly right with this stone. They talked about it. If they don't put it in the right position, Wayne Middaugh is going to have a chance to go for his two, and he'd be able to take the skin. So the line and the weight, so critical in this one.
Ed Werenich, four-time skins champion.
Tight.
Lots of room.
Tight.
One says lots of room, the other one says tight.
Tight.
Lots of weight. Well, lots of room, too.
Right. Off.
Back of the button.
Yep.
That looked to me like it was almost catching debris or pebble or something because it really died again. And look how much it curled once it got by the guard.
The one thing about this is that Eddie's got Wayne Middaugh playing the very soft shot, you know, as opposed to the big running shot. You can see Wayne keeps sneaking back to this running shot.
Right here. Roll there. Yeah.
Isn't that what we talked about at the very beginning?
Two raises for the win. If I make this good.
Want to tap that up for
us? Well, you don't want to freeze it, I don't think, because then he just wells on. What's that? Then he just wells on top of you. He's hoping I go here, and he just puts another one there. I think if I make this good, like this.
Yeah. Same shot as mine.
What's that?
Same shot as mine.
Yeah. I don't even need to. I don't want any more.
You can throw it even quieter, maybe.
Yeah. Right on the nose, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Right on the nose. The black rock will roll over.
Watch the right rock. We want it to come out a little bit on the outturn side, eh?
Plenty of time remaining for Middaugh. Just under 2 minutes remaining for Werenich as we play for $17,000 in the Skins Championship here in Denton.
Wayne can't catch hot rock with this one. Yep, he wants it to be in for second shot and roll open a little bit in case he needs to raise it.
You're hot, eh?
And the raise and the takeout, and he's lying one.
Some years they go for you that way.
Timeout.
Third timeout. And final timeout for Werenich.
I think I got to try to draw here.
I don't like that. There's room to make this.
I don't think there is. Straight spot, and then it starts to curl.
Now, look at how much room there is, Eddie.
Well, John wants to play this.
You can almost fan that rock.
Eddie wants to freeze down here like so. To come.
How about running the black one?
No, definitely not that. I think this is our shot.
I don't like that.
The freeze doesn't get you anything. All he's got to do is hit the 4 foot.
Yeah. 4 foot's tough to catch.
Then how does he get second shot?
Yeah, totally different philosophies. Playing the hit now to try and get rid of the rock so Wayne can't make the two versus trying to get it so Wayne can only get one by drawing in.
Maybe we'll get lucky and skin that one.
Oh, he's referring to the last shot.
Now here's Ed Werenich going down to throw a stone that he does not want to throw.
You really think that's there?
And he's still questioning.
You gotta hit it on the outside.
Yeah, it is a tough angle, and Wayne is eyeing it too. And this is it. Gotta make it.
Yeah.
I don't know. If you froze to the face of it, it's a very tough draw for 2 points.
Whoa, whoa! Yeah, really wide.
All the years of experience come into play here for Ed Werenich as he tries to save his championship.
Will it get by?
He said it was going to run straight, and it has. And now, you hit, you draw. Didn't like it. He never liked that shot.
Trying not to be wide on you.
Yeah, he's got a bad sliding.
Not bad. I got my arm into a bit, so I'll try and throw a little too hard.
Oh, my.
Nose hit for the money.
And the championship in 1995 here in Halifax. Wayne Middaugh.
Off.
No. Oh, finish.
Finish.
Sit right there. Men's Championship to Wayne Middaugh.
And there were several ends where those big weight shots didn't pay off, but finally Wayne had a pretty open hit for the skin and all the cash, and he made no mistake.
Scott Bailey, Ian Tetley, Graham McCarroll, and Wayne Middaugh pick up the big money, and they are the champions of the 1995 McCain TSN Skinscape.
When they saw the first fiberglass skis or the first graphite tennis racket, some people laughed.
They'll never laugh.
And when some people first saw the hammer, they had the same reaction.
Get serious. Where's the straw?
Then two-time Canadian and world champions Ed Werenich and Russ Howard chose the hammer.
The quick-change faceplates provide greater control under all types of ice conditions.
The hammer is the most effective sweeping device I've ever used.
Now who's laughing? For more information, call 1-800-567-7757.
Go for a healthy decision. Crisp crunch.
You can't beat that. McCain Super Fries is where it's at.
Great tasting crispy McCain Super Fries are prepared with 100% non-hydrogenated canola oil, so they contain just half a gram of saturated fat per serving.
More than that, they taste just great. So get the facts, they're on the pack.
McCain Super Fries, low in saturated fats for a healthy decision.
Now you can't beat that.
What's so new about new Speedstick Clear deodorant?
Take a look at this gel. See? It's wet and sticky. And mine, it goes on dry.
New Speedstick Clear. It's more than clear. It's clearly dry.
By Menon.
Hey, I'll take dry any day.
For all the curling news from across Canada, in fact, right around the world, you should subscribe to Canada's national curling magazine, The Curling News. Call toll-free 1-800-553-8003. The Curling News.
Inside a very special place, over 500,000 indelible memories of Canada's great passion. The Hockey Hall of Fame and Random House present a wonderful new volume containing over 300 photographs of great moments in hockey. The Spirit of the Game Collector's Edition is beautifully packaged in a special embossed case. Hockey fans will relive special moments in time, inspired by the greats of the game. Bobby Orr scoring and soaring after the Stanley Cup winner in 1970. Henri Richard celebrating with the Cup a record 11 times. The Spirit of the Game Collector's Edition is exclusively signed and numbered by these two great stars. Only 500 copies of this once-in-a-lifetime special edition are available with benefits to the Hockey Hall of Fame's charity of choice, Canadian Special Olympics. Here's how to order.
To order the limited edition of The Spirit of the Game for $175, use your credit card and call toll-free 1-800-923-2282. 1-800-923-2282.
Now it's time for the TSN Turning Point, and it's brought to you by Sony. When it comes down to your final stone.
Well, Wayne Middaugh had last rock in this end. Ed Wernick's trying to prevent the two in the skin by hitting his own rock onto the Middaugh stone that is shot rock. But he's not even going to get by the guard, rolls away, and leaves Wayne the wide-open hit for the skin, and that was all the cash right there.
A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of coaches in amateur sport on behalf of TSN and Sony. The new Sony Handycam Vision, clearly the latest in video cameras. Wayne Middaugh, we have a new king of skins, and he's with Ray.
Wayne, it all comes down to one end, and there's a lot of money on that end, wasn't there?
Yeah, there was a little bit of money on that end, for sure.
Not only is it a lot of cash here, it's a trip back next year. You were saying you've been here a few years in a row.
Yeah, next year will make it seven in a row. I kind of like this spiel.
This spiel. Listen, Eddie's last rock, he had to make a decision whether they're going to draw or play the hit. If he plays the draw, it cuts down your drawing position, but he decides to play the hit. What do you think about that?
I don't know. I think maybe the fact that I got such a lucky break on my first one might even flush him a bit, and he wasn't sure what he wanted to play. It really maybe made him take a step back a little and confuse him a little bit, because I got a huge break in my first one. I rubbed the guard, and turns out I make a great shot anyways, and really had no right to.
Well, Wayne, it was a tremendous game, and the skins format is really exciting when you get it coming down to a last end like that.
Oh, yeah, that's what you want. You know, when you're out here playing, you want it to come down to the last end, and hope Sonny makes a great shot to win.
Thank you very much, Vic. We have a new kid on the block.
You bet, and we're going to hear lots more from Wayne Middaugh. These two are certain to do battle in the Ontario Provincials. Wouldn't doubt that maybe Wayne Middaugh, Ed Werenich, could be the Ontario champion.
For the game.
Rob Clark, this is your Right Guard Sports moment.
Even under the most grueling conditions, Right Guard Sports Stick works to keep you dry, confident, and odor-free.
Rob, come on, relate.
Right Guard Sports Stick, right there when you need it.
Tune in to TSN Hockey Game Nights to see who scored big in the Gillette $25 million hockey pool. We'll announce the weekly winners of the JVC Big Screen TV and CCM hockey equipment. Find out if you're a winner.
I grew up with four brothers. Then I got a job to help the family. So every day I go out to work for three of my brothers. For the fourth, who is not here anymore, I go out to win.
Up here, winter comes early every year, as it has since the time of our ancestors. And up here, we know how to stay warm and dry. We wear these Sorel boots. They've been making them by hand for 86 years. Rugged, waterproof, good to 100 below. They last for years. This is good when you're as young as I. As we say in our language, Ayete Ege, be warm and dry.
Elvis Stoiko goes for the big one and gets the jump on taste. The taste of McCain Frozen Punch. Year-round thirst-quenching taste like grape. Orange and McCain Fruit Punch. Made with real fruit juices for real fruit taste that makes McCain the punch of champions like Elvis Stoiko. Get the jump on taste. The real fruit taste of McCain Frozen Punch.
Go for McCain. Get the jump on taste.
How far do you have to go for great tasting water? As far as your faucet. The Brita water filtration pitcher has the special Brita filter that reduces chlorine taste and lead, the things that nature never intended. And the taste? Wonderful. Brita. Better water, better gift idea.
On any given evening, in dozens of different countries, in any number of languages, the beer they're asking for is yours. A beer invented by Canadians, now enjoyed worldwide. Labatt Ice. Ice smooth, ice brewed. So, how do you feel about sharing your beer with half the planet?
Cool.
It's been quite a weekend here in Halifax. The 1995 McCain TSN Skins Game from the Mayflower Curling Club, all brought to you by McCain Foods, Canada's international food leader. Congratulations to Wayne Middaugh. They are the champions of the McCain TSN Skins.